I mean, I'm basically a professional now. I don't know what I'm doing. So let's just jump right in. Let's start connecting some wires and screwing some stuff into the board. I'm upgrading my solar from the Anchor Power Bank, which, by the way, has been great, to this setup, this Renogy setup. Here's the configuration I'm going with. So obviously, inverter, I'm going to do, there's the positive, my fuse, my positive fuse bus, my on-off switch, negative, bus bar. And I got a relay here. That's going to be so I can flip on and off the input from the solar panels. I forgot what that thing is, but it makes it safer. And my plan is to integrate all this stuff into a cart. I've got two 100 amp hour batteries that I think will be good enough for now. The two 100 amp hour batteries are going to go in the bottom of the cart. I got these cool off-road casters. So then I'll be able to wheel this cart around kind of like a giant power bank, basically, like an oversized thing that I've got already. I am completely winging this. I don't have any design for the cart yet. Just a picture in my head. Got help right here. He's a professional. He's here for moral support. Back to me not knowing what I'm doing. Trying to keep up with all the things. So here's how far I am. Now I need to order some solar wire because that's my solar breaker. And I guess I still need to do a negative from there to there. I got this green wire that hooks up down to there. And then I will drive a stake down into the ground. So that'll be my earth wire.
Got those wires ran to my
circuit breaker.
Now, my next plan is I'm basically going to cut this board off at the bottom. This is going to be the back wall of the cart. So basically, kind of just want to give myself enough room to have these batteries and however many more batteries I want to add later on here at the bottom. And I got enough room and I give myself a bit more. So there we go. Bam. That is my mark right there. Got these screws sticking out. Just gonna go ahead and clean that up real quick. I can give that a good snap-a-roo. Oh yeah, that's looking good. All right, it's coming along nicely. I have ordered some 10 gauge wire for the solar panels. To go out to the solar panels. Basically, what this is gonna look like, the base of the cart, then I'll just run the positive from there, down, get my negative. I'll probably run my negative over here and then put some big off-road wheels under there. It's gonna be sweet.
All right, we're back at it. I've been dealing with wind today, so I've been cleaning up all the damage and messes that the weather has been causing, but back at the solar. Here's where I'm at right now. I found a base, which just so happens to be the perfect length. Basically, this is how wide it's going to be. I'm going to have 2x4s running down the base of it here, so I'm just going to cut this here, and this is where the batteries are going to sit. All right, I'm just cut these vertical 2x4s, gonna run it like so. Then what I'll probably end up doing, since the plugs are right there, is just drill a hole when I end up putting the cover on this side. I've got it all framed in. Now I just need to add the bottom. There we go. Got the floor mounted on there.
Okay. I'm back from town. I got my bolts. I guess technically these are screws. Let's screw in some wheels.
There we have it. It is officially a cart. Now I just gotta run the positive from there down to the battery, the negative up to there.
And then I'm gonna go test it out before I do any more work, before I put the roof on and the front panel.
The front panel, I might wanna make it a door so that it swings up on hinges. And then also the roof, I might want to make it so that it swings up on hinges.
And I plan on making it a slope so that when it rains, the water will run off. Okay, the only thing I don't have hooked up apart from the solar panels, is the earth. I don't have it. I'm going to put a copper rod into the ground there. So, yeah. Maiden voyage right here. Let's see if things start smoking or catch on fire. Nothing happened. What if I do this? Okay. Got some lights coming on here. 12.8 volts. Again, I have not read the instructions, so I don't know what's going on. Actually, I might just wheel it down there and test it out. See if it powers the trailer. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Got my big old off-road tires. Oh, I've crashed. I've already crashed it. Hasn't tipped over yet.
All right, I'm gonna turn it on. See what happens. I've got no solar power or solar panels hooked up to it yet, so this is just a power test. And it didn't like it. No, never mind. I just heard the power kick on in the trailer, so we're all good. It's running. So now that I know it's working, all I need to do, then I'll be drilling some more holes here to run the solar cables. So now that I know I have a functioning setup as far as supplying power goes, I'm gonna go ahead and save the rest of work for the next video. I'll be putting a front panel on there, a roof, and I would like the roof definitely to hinge open, and then possibly the front panel as well. And then after I get all that done, I'm going to go ahead and paint it, either, I don't know, desert sand color maybe, so it blends in. And then I got to secure the batteries and do some grinding on some washers here, because casters don't turn that well. So that concludes another episode. Thanks for being here, and I'll catch you on the next one.